100 or more, headache, cough, sore throat, difficulty breathing, shortness of breath, nausea, vomiting, any change in taste or smell?
Nope.
No? Great. All right. Well, here's your backpack with your Chromebook, your lunch, your water, your charger, and of course, your mask. Have a great day.
Good morning, Owen. How are you doing?
Doing good. How about you?
Good. I'm glad you made it on time.
Glad to be here.
Why don't you come on in and get some hand sanitizer on, and how's everything going?
Going good. Going
Class
good.
Is doing okay so far?
So far.
That's great. We're going to have a terrific year, Owen.
Awesome. Good to be here.
Go ahead.
What's up, Mr. Valencia? How you doing? Oh, good to
Marcus.
See you.
I'm sorry, Marcus. We can't shake hands. Where's your mask, Marcus?
Forgot it at home.
Okay, well, let me ask you. You look like you've been traveling. Where have you been, Marcus?
Yeah, man. Florida, the Sunshine State. Beautiful, sunshine, sandy beaches.
Wow, Marcus. Marcus, how long ago did you get back?
Yesterday.
Oh, Marcus, unfortunately, according to the Connecticut executive order, you have to quarantine for 14 days before you can come back to school. So I'm not going to be able to let you in the building today. You're going to have to stay home and take your classes virtually for the next 14 days before we can let you back into the building. I'm really sorry, Marcus, but I hope you understand.
Oh, I understand. Well, keeping the students safe. I get it. Thank See you, Mr. Blunt.
Make sure to put on that mask, Marcus.
Will do.
Thank you.
Fourth period lunchtime.
Stop! You're going the wrong way. Look at the arrows. No lockers. Dryer. Use the paper towels. What do you think you're doing, pal?
I don't feel like going all the way around to the front today.
Auditorium entrance.
Mr. Valencia, high five!
6 feet apart, gentlemen.
Dear Notre Dame families, the pandemic response team has been working all summer on our plans for reopening school in the fall. We've created 3 plans that we can easily use as safety metrics and guidelines develop. These are designed so that the school can move seamlessly from one plan to the next as needed. Based on current information, we have decided to begin the year in the blended learning, the gold plan model. We're very excited to be able to have our students back in the building, even if it is at half capacity, as this allows us to accomplish a safe campus while giving our students the face-to-face interaction that is most crucial in their learning. The goal, of course, is to get all of our students back in the building as soon as possible. However, we will only do this when it is safe to do so. We also understand that there are families who are not comfortable sending their sons into the building and have created guidelines for remote learning as well. We will be starting the actual school year on September 8th. We'll be having orientation meetings with our students by grade, beginning with the seniors on Monday, August 31st. Each class will have a half-day program to get them familiar with their teachers and the new procedures needed to maintain the building safe. The blended learning or gold plan creates 2 cohorts of students, freshmen and sophomores, and juniors and seniors, and has each cohort in the building twice per week, with the other 2 days of virtual remote learning. We will follow a 7-period day. Wednesdays will have all faculty and staff working from home so that the building can be thoroughly cleaned and teachers can be available to give students additional support from home. All students have the option of attending classes virtually. Please contact Mr. Ramirez or Mr. Valencia by August 24th if this is what your family decides to do. The Green Plan, a full return of all students, will be implemented as soon as the situation allows. The Blue Plan, where all students and faculty teach and learn from home, may also be used should safety concerns warrant it. Winkle buses plan on running at full capacity. Masks must be worn at all times while on the bus. To maintain a safe environment in the building, hallways and stairwells will be one-directional, water fountains will not be in use, bathroom capacity will be limited, and students will be bringing backpacks instead of using their lockers. Most importantly, everyone in the building will wear a mask at all times, and social distancing guidelines will be followed. To ensure further safety monitoring, students will only enter the building throughout the front auditorium door or the back auditorium door. The building will be open at 7:30 in the morning. If a student must be there before 7:30, please contact Mr. Ramirez. Notre Dame will be closed to all visitors at this time. To achieve social distancing and allow for contact tracing, classroom desks will be 6 feet apart wherever possible, and students will be seated alphabetically. Doors and windows will remain open. Hand sanitizers and disinfectant wipes will be available in every classroom. We are currently working with our food provider to have lunch available for students. These will be eaten in their fourth period classrooms. For now, we are reimagining all assemblies so that we can present information to larger groups. As per World Health Organization guidelines, most of the building's air conditioning units may not be used while students are in the building. Should weather conditions become prohibitively warm, we will move to virtual remote learning for that day. It is important for parents to know the procedures and policies regarding symptoms, testing, and quarantining of members of the community as we reopen school. Most importantly, parents are urged not to send their students to school if that student has a fever of 100 or greater, has a cough, a sore throat, has shortness of breath, difficulty breathing, muscle pain, chills, headache, changes in taste or smell, nausea, vomiting, or diarrhea. Notre Dame will follow State of Connecticut cleaning and disinfection guidelines, has purchased an electrostatic machine to be used throughout the day to disinfect surfaces, and has allocated additional resources to maintain the building as clean as possible. We are very invested in keeping our students healthy from the social and emotional side as well. Our school counselors, teachers, coaches, administration, and staff are all committed to the well-being of our students, and we will be available to them. Our school is also committed to keeping the faith community strong and has reimagined how campus ministry will look like this year. Clubs and extracurricular activities will also be active. Club meetings will be held daily from 2:30 p.m. to 3 p.m., with students being able to attend virtually. And finally, Notre Dame will follow CIAC guidelines in regards to sports. It is important that athletes not attend practice if they are not feeling well, and all athletes must be picked up when practice ends. Students will not be allowed to be in the building while waiting to be picked up. Thank you very much for your attention, and we hope to have a wonderful year at Notre Dame.